Welcome to the Scorpion God. I hope you're excited for a clear board state with a bunch of removal. I am. As far as opening hand goes, yeah, not too wild about this one. Let's go to Mulligan. All right, Smoldering Marsh, Blood Kit, Rakdos Return. Yeah, we can make this work. I'd like a little bit more card draw, but I'll be okay with that. We're going to keep on this one. See if our opponent wants to mulligan past six or not. Play against Creepy Baby, Child of Alara Baby. Hopefully we can keep that baby off the battlefield. Okay, opponent did mulligan to six. As far, yeah, we'll go keep on this one. I don't mind this hand. See if they want to mulligan past six or not on this one. Okay, and the command tower on top. Yes, I'll put that on top in a heartbeat. Let's go and lead off with the Smoldering Marsh, and then I'll cover our commanders in just a second. Let's go and get that down. Anything else, we're going to pass the turn. We are playing the Scorpion God. Whenever a creature with a minus one counter on it dies, draw a card. Then for three mana, put a minus one counter on another target creature. Whenever the Scorpion God dies, return it to its owner's hand at the beginning of the next end step. We're going to draw into that command tower. Let's go and lead off with the Blood Crypt. That sounds good. Not going to pay two. And then we're going to go and pass the turn. Playing against Child of Alara, Creepy Baby. Wooburg, whenever Child of Alara dies, destroy all non-land permanents. They cannot be regenerated because Child of Alara has some really creepy art. Yep. I don't know. That's really weird looking to me. I don't know. I think the thing that really creeps me out, it has a baby's face, but it kind of has like that forearm bone looking thing to it. And it's like a newborn baby. I don't know. It's really... makes me uncomfortable, really, if you want to think about it. All right, let's go to get the, wonderful, Thought Vessel, I like it. Let's get down Thought Vessel, it's going to be one and two, and then anything else, we're going to go and pass the turn. But yes, welcome to the Scorpion God. I have not played the Scorpion God in a long time. I'm really excited about it. I love playing the Scorpion God because we have tons of removal in here. We have tons of answers for everything, and in fact, I played against Animar earlier, and if I splice the video onto this one, you'll see the video. It'll probably be after this or something like that, but anyway... I'll make this video after because I'm about to talk about it. But they play against Animar, and they got a really nice board state going. And then we had no removal in the hand, so we just fire off at like a what is that? It's the card where you discard a card and you draw two cards. I can see it has Ugin on it. Anyway, we go for that. We need a board wipe, and we draw into two board wipes. We draw into Crux of Fate and then Toxic Deluge, and just wreck. Just really take advantage of our opponent's board state. Really clear everything out. And then we just kept hitting removal after removal after removal, taking care of Animar. And it felt really good to kind of beat up on Animar. And as far as what we can go for, we do have Gamble in the hand. Do we want to gamble for a Phyrexian Arena? I like it. It's a good thing to gamble for. Let's go and do that. We're going to gamble for Phyrexian Arena at this point right now. We need to get some card draw going. All right, let's pop this out just a little bit. Make sure we don't click on the wrong card. Phyrexian Arena. Fingers crossed! All right, anything else? We're going to go past the turn. God, that hurts. That always... that stings the nostrils. I hate that when that happens. But that's gamble, though. It's such your red tutor for you. And one of the best things in Magic is, you know, when your opponent, they cast gamble. And you can kind of tell what they're going to gamble for based on, you know, like our opponent knows that if we had Phyrexian Arena, we would have slammed that down, like, really quick. But it's always funny whenever your opponent goes for gamble and you see what goes into the bin. You're like, I bet that's what they gambled for. So... jigs up on that one. Let's see what our opponent's saying. See? Yep. they guessed it. Opponent's going to go for Bajuka Bog. Why not? Just rub some salt into the wound. Then get rid of it. It's exiled out of here. But yeah, our opponent guessed it. But yes, that's one of the best things in Magic is when you can kind of tell what they gambled for and it hits the bin. You're like, oh. Yes, indeed. All right, see what opponent's going to get down. That's going to be three total mana. Get down the Veteran War Leader. Power toughness equal number of creatures you control. Tap an untapped ally against First Strike, Vengeance, or Trample end of turn. So, might be playing against five-color allies. Seems like that might be a fun match. Now, we do have Splendid Agony in the hand. So, what we can do is we go Splendid Agony, two minus one counters. Put one on the Veteran War Leader and put one on the Eldrazi Spawn. So the Eldrazi Spawn is going to die, and then that minus one counter is going to take care of the Veteran War Leader. So I think we're going to go for that play this turn. I like that. Kind of leaves us open on Skin Render. That way, if we want to go for something next turn. And a nice two for one. It always feels really good. Scorpion God likes it. We're going to choose both of these creatures. Click OK. We're going to choose black. There we go. All right, take care of them. Oh, yes, tool time grant. And we've got our own Bajuka Bog. Why not? Let's go for it. Going to target our opponent, get rid of their graveyard. And then we're going to go and pass the turn. That will put us online for the Scorpion God next turn, which we can go for. And go beat sticks with the Scorpion God. If you have not seen the Scorpion God, it's actually mainly just kind of control. We get tons of removal in here. And then we have a very heavy Scorpion I guess you can call it that. We have a very heavy Voltron package in here. Ouch. Yeah, sorry, man. Sorry about that. I had to get something going after that gamble whiffed. But yeah, so we do have a Voltron package in here. Mainly what the gameplay and what we're doing with Scorpion God is we just basically keep everything off the battlefield, get down the Scorpion God, and then start to go beat sticks with something like Sword of Feast and Famine or Sword of Fire and Ice, which is just a very delightful magic. It's playing this deck's a lot like playing Jund in Modern. You know, it's a very War of Attrition style game. And then using the Scorpion God, once we kind of get that mana flowing with a bunch of mana rocks, we can start putting those minus one counters on opponent's creatures and using our removal as just kind of just advantage for us to swing with the Scorpion God and really taking advantage of some really good card draw, which is always fun because I love drawing cards. Yeah, that's pretty much LOL. Sorry, but not sorry. Yeah, sorry. No, not really. All right, see our opponent's going to get down. Hopefully this will be a good one. All right, opponent's going to go for Beast Caller Savant. That does have haste, so they can add that mana to their mana pool. But it looks like we are playing its five-color allies, so I always enjoy that. All right, swinging in for one. Set the tone. It's going to put us down to 29. I like it. Now, we do have Rakdos Return in the hand. They do have two cards that we could go for with that. That's going to wipe them out. It's going to put them online for getting down Child of Alara. Do we want to go for the Scorpion God? We could Faithless Loot in hopes of hitting a land drop with discard two cards. I kind of like what we got going on. Let's go for the Scorpion God. I like that. It's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Get that down. Either way, there's been a nice back and forth, at least as far as the beginning of the game goes. So hopefully it'll go ahead and post this one up. But yeah, let's go and get the Scorpion God down. And then early, I don't know what happened in our earlier match, but something happened to where we're going to send the Scorpion God to the graveyard. And it went back to the command zone for some reason. So I don't know if I got a little bit too festive with the clicks and accidentally double-clicked it on something like that. I don't know. But who knows. All right, kick it over to our opponent. We could have gone for Rakdos Return, but yeah, I don't know. We could have. We'll see. See what they kind of want to deploy out. Worst case scenario, we'll just go for Faithless Loot and kind of dig for a board wipe or something like that. Oh, but in non-magic news, every year, I have a group of friends that I went to college with. Every year we have a Christmas dinner. And we go out to eat at a really nice restaurant. Basically, it's kind of the one event a year that we all dress up and act civilized for a night and then act uncivilized afterwards. But mainly, we just go, ooh, Genesis for 5? All right, let's go for that. And that's going to be Forest, got the Archer, got the Grove Tender Druids, and the Plant Token, and then target creature gets -1 until end of turn, Sunken Hollow. Okay, that's not too bad. I'll Genesis for 5. But yeah, so we have an annual Christmas dinner, and it's actually the 10th annual Christmas dinner that we've done. And had a lot of fun. We went out, and the place I went to is a really nice restaurant. It's called Hattie's in Dallas, if you want to look it up, kind of see their menu. I had it was quail wrapped in bacon with jalapeno stuff in there, and that was, it was really good. Normally, when we go to these restaurants, I get like a steak or something like that. And man, opponents, that Grove, Tender Druids, I didn't realize that's pretty brutal getting those plant tokens going. But yeah, normally when I go to these nice restaurants, I tend to get a steak. And I don't know, I never eat quail, especially wrapped in bacon or stuffed with jalapenos. So I got that. The only thing I didn't like was I do like sweet potatoes. It was on a bed of sweet potatoes with collard greens. And I like sweet potatoes, but like literally only on Thanksgiving. That's about it. Outside of Thanksgiving, I'm just not a huge fan of sweet potatoes. I don't know why. Just don't. All right, we probably should have gone for that Rakdos Return. Opponent going for the Genesis Wave. So opponents, as far as our board state goes, we're looking at 3, 6. That's going to be 7, 8, 9. We can get a few count. Yeah, we need to take care of that Druid to kind of stop those plant tokens from coming down. Let's go and do that. And then we can still Faithless Loot and get rid of the Darksteel Plate if we need to. Let's go and do that first. Let's go for Faithless Looting. We're going to tap out for red, draw two cards, discard two cards. Then we can just get rid of the Rakdos Returns, kind of depending on what we draw into. Okay, we draw into Dragon Skull Summit and Care Keep. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I kind of want to keep making the land drops for the turn. Yeah, let's go and get rid of the Darksteel Plate. I would love to hold on to the Darksteel Plate. I would love to hold on to it, but I'm going to keep making our land drops so we have some mana to start utilizing the Scorpion God, to be honest. Let's go and do that. Let's get rid of Rakdos Return. Darksteel Plate. Yeah, I'd like to hold on to it, but we don't have a board wipe to go alongside with it. We'll make it work. Let's go and get down the Dragon Skull Summit. Let's go and go for Skin Render on the Druid. We'll still get a card draw off that. Tap out for the Thought Vessel. Tap out the Blood Crypt. Get those 3-1 counters on the Grove Tender. Get a card draw off that. Draw into Expedition Map. Wonderful. Go and get that down. than anything else. I think we're just going to go and pass the turn. Yeah, I like that. This board state's not too daunting at this point right now. Our opponent does have the activation off the sharpshooter. We're looking at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So they go for two activations with the minus 1, minus 1. Not going to be able to take care of the Skin Render or the Scorpion God, so we're kind of in a good spot right now. But yeah, as far as dinner goes, I had that the quail. It was on a bed of mashed sweet potatoes and collard greens, so I wasn't a huge fan of that. Didn't really eat that. And then whenever it enters the battlefield, creatures control get plus 2 until end of turn, or another ally. All right, it's pretty festive on that one. I love the... it's kind of digital looking art, but it didn't look that bad. But yeah, I had that, and then for... as far as my drinks go, I had some key lime martinis. Those are pretty good. Enjoyed it. I'm usually not a martini fan, but I love key lime. And they had key lime there, and so I had key lime martini, and that was just absolutely wonderful. And it was just a great night. You know, there's about 12 of us, but one of the couples that normally goes, they recently had a baby about a month ago, so they couldn't make it, could not attend it. That's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's going to be one activation. Yeah, I guess we jump block on one of the plant tokens. Because that's going to be 3 damage counters, and they go for 1 minus 1. It's going to be... man, I'd hate to lose a Scorpion God on something funky like that. We could go for the Scorpion God and block on one of the plant tokens, but they still have an open activation. I don't know. I'd hate to lose it to something like Lightning Bolt or something. I don't know. All right. Good in for 6. That's fine. Put it down to 23. Yeah, I had Key Lime Martini. And then for dessert, they had a Key Lime Tart that I had. Once again, keeping on theme with the Key Lime brand. Very happy with that. And then what did my wife had? She had a filet mignon. It's like a mac and cheese filet mignon. Really good. Enjoyed it. But yeah, as far as the restaurant goes, it was kind of like I'm trying to think how to describe it. It was like a home-style kitchen restaurant. Like that was the style of food that they're going for. It was like the southern comfort food kind of. All right, but it's going to go for Keranos. Get that down. Very interesting. I like Keranos in here. Really good carb. And then right at this point right now, we just kind of need to draw into a board wipe. We'll be able to kind of get rid of all these allies onto the battlefield. And we do have enough mana. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We're sitting at 6 mana. There'll be 7 with the land drop. So we can start putting some minus 1 counters on some of those creatures. The main thing is we want to get rid of this Warcaller out there. It's going to be one of the first things that we go for. Okay, let's go get down the Care Keep. Let's see. Huh? What are we going to do on this one? Let's go and go for... so we can take care of two creatures. We can take care of the Warcaller, which is something we need to do right now. So if we go for that, it's going to be 3 mana. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It's going to be 7 total that we can go for. 2 off the expedition map. We'll get down the Care Keep. Yeah, let's go and do the... let's get down the Crumbling Ashes. It's going to be black and then Care Keep. And let's go ahead and go for the Scorpion God activation on the War Caller. I like that. So we're looking at black, red, and then tap down the Thought Vessel. It still keeps us online for Expedition Map. We'll be able to draw into another card. Mainly want to keep that plus 2 bonus off the battlefield. Ooh, Swiftfoot Boots. Yeah, let's go ahead and get that down. I like that. Get on Swiftfoot Boots. Could go for the Expedition Map crack, but I like getting that down so I can get it on the Scorpion God. Now, do we want to swing in at this point? That's going to be 3-4 coming across. Do we want to push in? Get some commander damage going. Yeah, I think I like pushing in on this one. They have 0 cards in hand. I like leaving Skin Render out, but they can chump block on pretty much anything our opponent has out there. If they want to just load up on a bunch of creatures, sure, go for it. All right, get in for 6 commander damage. Then anything else, we're going to go and pass the turn. It's really not that far-fetched to get commander damage with the Scorpion God. I mean, it adds up really quick, especially, I think, I may be wrong, but I'm pretty sure we have Rogue's Passage in here, which... I'm getting a second. I don't have my second monitor just yet, so I'm really excited to get that. And then I'll be able to have my deck list up. And in fact, let's go ahead and just let's hop over there real quick, just to kind of see what we've got as far as unblockable stuff goes for the Scorpion God. Click on this. Sorry about this, guys. But hey, needs to be done. Make sure we have a accurate game plan to start going for. Clicked on the Scarab God. Where are you, Scorpion God? There we go. One more down. Do we have that in here? We do not have Rogue's Passage. I'm pretty sure there's something that allows us to swing in. Let's go and hop back over to the board state. Kind of spin a little too. All right, Poto's going to go for Child of Valar. Sure, get that down. All right. Now, with Child of Valar, what they can do, whenever it dies, destroy all non-land permanents that can't be regenerated. That's going to be we're not really going to lose that much. I mean, we're going to have the expedition map, which we're going to crack. We're going to miss out on crumbling ashes and swiftfoot boots. So if we do get into a board wipe and they kind of blow everything up with the Child of Valar, not really going to be the end of the world. If we miss out on crumbling ashes, it's not too bad. Now, the main thing that we can do is with crumbling ashes, we can start getting that minus one counter on some creatures. Now, that will trigger at the beginning of our upkeep, so we don't have no way to make sure that... Since there's no creatures with a minus one counter on it, we're not going to be able to like stack it to where we can get a minus one counter and get that crumbling ashes to trigger. All right, opponent's going to be swinging in. It's going to be one coming across. Yeah, that's fine. Go for it. It's going to be 3/5. Put us down to 18. And we still have Faith of Saluting out of the bin to go for that, too. All right, see what we draw into. Draw into Night's Whisper. Wonderful. I love it. It's going to go for that. Looking at black. I'm going to tap the Care Keep. Well, I can actually tap the Thought Muscle Dome. Draw two cards, lose two life. Looking for a board wipe at this point right now. And the good thing about a board wipe is it destroys all non-land permanents. You know, we're going to lose the Scorpion God, but if something does happen, we can bounce it back to the hand, kind of get around that commander tax. All right. Bowfly Infestation. So we can kind of chain some stuff together. Let's go and do that. Do we have enough mana to go for that activation? It's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We do not have enough. Did we make the land drop for the turn? We have not gone for the land drop. Let's go and crack the expedition map. Let me get down Ancient Tomb. We get down Bowfly Infestation and also get down more Power Stone. Really have some mana to kind of go hog wild next turn. Let's get down the Ancient Tomb. It's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, let's go and do that. Let's go for the Bowfly Infestation. It's gonna be 1/2. And let's go and put a plus one counter. Let's go and equip the Swiftfoot Boots onto the Scorpion God. Now, as far as I'm swinging in on the crackback, that's gonna be 1, 2, 3, 4. It's gonna be 10. Looking at 13 coming across. If they want to swing the Child of Valar, we can pretty much chump block on anything else out there. It's not gonna be great, but we can chain the Bowfly Infestation to where we can start really kind of putting some minus one counters on some of those creatures. In fact, let's go and put the Swiftfoot Boots onto the Scorpion God, give it some protection, and then we're just gonna go ahead and pass the turn. We don't want to allow our opponent to swing into kind of pretty much anything. Or have a free open board state. So we'll get the Swiftfoot Boots onto the Scorpion God. That would kind of dodge the Keranos trigger. But actually, now that I think about it, if they go for Keranos, deal 3 damage to us, puts us down to 11. We can always chump block on Child of Valar to kind of stop most of that damage. But they get down the Blade Master that popped up. Enters the battlefield. Creatures you control gain double strike until end of turn. All right. Ooh. They get that down. That actually. That might get us on that one. It's going to be 1, 2, 2, 4. The elf is not an ally. Excuse me, the plant token is not an ally because it's going to be double strike. Whenever that enters the battlefield or another ally you control, creatures you control gain double strike. Okay, yeah, that's actually going to give everybody double strike. Okay, opponent's going to go for the archer. Get that down. It's going to cross off the wood elves. Cross that off. Yeah, it's going to be double strike. I think it's going to get them. Get game to our opponent. Maybe we should have gone for Rakdos Return earlier. We would have stopped that Genesis Wave, but hey, it is what it is. All right, but it's going to be swinging with Child of Valar. In fact, we'll just go and let this one come through because I don't think with that double strike, they're going to get it. Good game. Get that out there. I always enjoy playing as five color allies. All right, but it's going to be swinging in and then put us down to -2 with that first strike damage and then that double strike damage on the back end. We'll take care of it. So if you enjoyed the video, like and subscribe. Sorry we didn't get a Scorpion God win. We always try for it, but hey, it happens. So, all right, bye.